بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم وصلی اللہ علی النبی الکریم رب اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی. The theme for today's talk is the end of history, the end of human history. Recent changes in world climate are every day in the news. Every day we find in media some new news about this danger. Scientific community is continuously warning us that we have little time. They say that up to 2015, that is only after 8 years, the whole life support system will be jeopardized. It is very dangerous. We have only 8 years. I think that this is the most dangerous news ever anyone have heard in this world. But according to my experience, everyone is happy. I don't find anyone who took it as a concern, except scientific community. Only scientific community is in anxiety. Every day they warn us. So it is very, very dangerous situation. You know, recently there was a meeting in Berlin, in the capital city of Germany, of G8, that is group of 8 most developed nations. So all the heads of these nations participated in this conference. According to the media report, the most occupied item of their agenda was global warming. But in vain, there was no result. So Times of India, in its issue June 10, have published a report about this G8 conference. The caption is, "Too broke to save the world." Too broke to save the world. It means that too helpless to save the world. Everyone is helpless. Scientific community is helpless. All the bigs are helpless. Who can fight with the nature? No one is so powerful to fight the nature. So it is not very simple. It is very, very important. According to my experience, it is a divine warning. It is a sign that God has rejected our civilization. Why? Because man has lost L-O-S-T. Man has lost his justification to stay born on this planet Earth. Man has lost his justification to stay on this Earth. Why? It is a very, very sincere issue. We have to link it with the creation plan of God. Otherwise, we cannot understand the seriousness of this issue and the nature of this issue. So, according to my analysis, this problem is directly linked with the creation plan of God. I will try to give some detail of the creation plan. You know, God created Adam as first man and Eve as the first lady. They were settled in paradise. God said, "Fakula minha ragadan haythu shaytuma." We are free. Enjoy all those things. But don't approach to this tree. There was a forbidden tree. And God said to Adam, don't approach to this tree, and don't eat, and don't eat the fruit of this tree. Don't eat the fruit of this tree. But Adam was overpowered by his temptation, and he ate the fruit of that forbidden tree. After this, God said, go from paradise. God threw them in this planet Earth. God settled them in this planet Earth and said that now you have to prepare yourself. You have to prove your deservation. So, this planet Earth is a preparatory ground. We are here only for one purpose, that we must prepare ourselves to be a deserving candidate for paradise. So, all those things, all those items, we find in this earth is not as a reward, is not as a right. All these things are provided to us only to give facilities to prepare ourselves. So all these things are facilities rather than reward. So we have to prepare ourselves. All the life support system and family and society, all those things that are available in this planet Earth is only for preparation. It is fast, it is a preparatory period. But man altered the divine plan. He said, no, this earth is for enjoyment. They formulated that eat, drink, and be merry. God's formula was prepare yourself for paradise. Stay on this earth and prepare yourself for paradise. But man adopted a new theory, a new formula, that was eat, drink, and be merry. So, according to this formula, they created a whole civilization. Our modern civilization is only an expression of this formula. So, man tried to accumulate all kind of comfort, all kind of luxury, all kind of desire. So the present world was not meant for this purpose. It was a deviation from the God's plan. Present earth was meant only for preparation, for us it was a preparatory period. All those things that were provided for us only to give us opportunities, like life support system, water and light and oxygen, and then peace and society and family. All these things were not blessing. No, all these things were facilities. To give us opportunity to prepare ourselves. So God's formula was prepare yourself for paradise. And man invented a new formula. Eat, drink, and be merry. So God waited up to thousand and thousand years, so that man may reassess the situation, man may revise himself and change his lifestyle and follow the divine path. But man failed. Only some exceptions were there. Only some individuals, not the society, not the nation, not the humanity, only some individuals exceptionally adopted the divine formula. They tried to prepare themselves for paradise. But the majority followed another formula, that was eat, drink, and be merry. So after a long time, they lost the justification to stay here. So I think that it is not present global warming is not a simple thing. It is a God's rejection. It is a rejection from God. And it is irreversible. Now the time is to reassess. Now the time is to revise our ideology, to change in our lifestyle, to reassess the whole situation. There is no other option for us. So this is the, I think that global warming is a global warning, a divine warning. And maybe it is the final call. Now let us know what is the option before us, what we have to do. I think that the only option before us is to prepare ourselves for paradise. And what is that preparation? First of all, we have to discover God, the Creator. This is the first condition. There is a hadith, kuntu kandam makhfiya fa aradtu an urafa fa khalaqtu al khalq. I was a hidden treasure, then I wanted to be known, so I created mankind. It means that God created the world, God created everything, but for us it is unseen. It is beyond our capacity to see it like other things. We can see Himalayan mountain, we can see seas and oceans, but we cannot see God. But at the same time, God has given us mind. Although through this eye, we cannot see God. But by using our mind, we can see God. We can realize God. We can discover God. So this is the first condition. We have to contemplate we have to ponder over the nature, over the creation. Also, we have to study the revealed books. We have to study Quran and Hadith literature. So, after observation, after study, after contemplation, we have to discover God through our mind. This is the first condition. This is called marifa, or iman, or faith. Faith is not simply a recitation. Faith means discovery. Faith means realization. So, first of all, we have to concentrate our mind in this issue. Who created this universe? Who created myself? We have to go to these questions so that we may discover God Almighty, the creator of the universe. So after this discovery is not a very simple. This discovery, if it is true discovery, it will change your personality. It will bring about a revolution in your mind. So, if we discover God, we will discover all other things. God is the central idea. If God is discovered, everything is discovered. So, discovery of God is discovery of everything. So, after this discovery, we will see that the whole life is changed. One who discovers God, his thinking is changed, his behavior is changed, his moral values are changed, his activities are changed. So, this is what is required. People are busy to accumulate consumer items and comfortable items and luxurious items. It is quite unwanted according to the creation plan of God. According to the creation plan of God, you are not here to live a life of happiness, to enjoy. No. All kind of luxury, all kind of comfort is in the paradise, not here. So, you have to know the real issue before death. God has divided, God has created us as a eternal being, but he divided our life into two parts, pre-death period and post-death period. So we are here only to prepare ourselves as a deserving candidate for paradise. But man failed. All men and women, with few exceptions, all men and women with few exceptions are engaged to accumulate luxury and comforts and happiness and consumer goods. They are engaged in outing, in shopping. All these things are not wanted by God. So God waited up to a long time. Then he rejected. Now man is a rejected lot. Now our civilization is a rejected lot. This I am saying because in the Quran and in the Hadith, this was foretold. Global warming is not new for religious literatures. If you read Hadith literature, you will find that there are dozens of Hadith in which the Prophet of Islam has warned, has foretold that in the later days before doomsday, sun will be very near. Although according to my knowledge, I can say that it is not in literal sense. Here sun means its temperature, its heat. Due to some reason, its heat will be increased. Sun will not come to us, but its heat will be increased. That is the case in which we are facing today. Everyone knows that temperature is rising. It's a very difficult time for living creatures. Many, many creatures are dying every day. All those fragile animals are dying every day. This is the beginning of death. So, this is not, we cannot ignore it. At present, people are living like ostrich. So, ostrich habit will not do. I see, it is said that when an ostrich feels that a storm is coming, sign the storm is coming. So he puts his head in the sand when he feels that sandstorm is coming, there is a message of death for him. But instead of facing that sandstorm, he only puts his head in the sand. So this is, we cannot afford like having, we cannot afford to do like ostrich. Ostrich habit is not affordable for us. Ostrich is an animal. Ostrich can afford this. Because after death, there is no life for ostrich. When an ostrich dies, it dies forever. There is no life after death for ostrich. But we, our case is quite different. Our case is quite different. When man dies, his death is only temporary. Just after death, he is revived in the world hereafter. So we cannot afford ostrich-like behavior. We have to know the gravity of the situation. So we have to refashion our life. It is very, very dangerous issue. If you read the religious literature, you will find that in every religious literature, there are predictions. In almost every religious literature, there is a prediction that in later days, someone will come and he will solve all the issues. So people are waiting that mysterious person. In every religion, Buddhism, Jainism, Hinduism, Christianity, Judaism, and also Islam. Even in Baha'ism, in every religion, there is a belief according to their scriptures that someday a very strange personality will emerge. And this personality will solve all the problems. But I think that all these things are simply dream. People are waiting. There is a line in the Persian, مرد از غیب برو آئے دو کارے بکند. Someone will appear and he will do all the things mysteriously. But I don't believe that anyone is coming with mysterious powers, with miraculous powers. Now the history is heading to its end. All the signs indicate that history is heading to its end. You see, when there is no, when there is no water on this earth, when there is no life support system on this earth, when there is no balance, present balance, so how you can live on this earth? So people are waiting for some mysterious person, and time is running. Time is running out. Time is running out. I don't think that any mysterious person is coming, any miraculous personality is coming. No. We have to understand the gravity of the situation. I think there is no other option for us. We cannot wait for a mysterious personality. No. Time is running out. So we have to awake. We have to awake. So it is very important to know that this world was not created as a blessing for us. This world was not created for us to live here with, to acquire pleasure, to enjoy. No. The world was not meant for these purposes. This world was a preparatory ground. All those things that are available in this planet, they are only to facilitate our preparation. All those things which we see on this earth were only to facilitate our preparation. So we have to rethink, we have to redefine, we have to rediscover. Otherwise, we will suffer. We will pay very heavy price for this ignorance. The first thing is required to understand that we are not here. We are here not for enjoyment. We are here not for enjoyment. We are here only to prepare ourselves. You know what is preparation? Preparation means to prepare our personality. To discover the truth. To live with divine principles. To save us from temptations. Our case is just like Adam. Adam was told that don't approach to this tree. But he was overpowered by his temptation and he ate the fruit of that forbidden tree. Then he was thrown to this earth. Now it is a very, very serious matter. First time Adam was thrown to this planet earth, but now if man committed the same sin, if man remitted the same sin, then there is no other planet earth for him. Then there is no other planet earth for him. The other planet is hell. Adam committed a sin. Adam was overpowered by his temptations and he was thrown to this planet earth. But now the generation of Adam, we all are generation of Adam. If we remitted that kind of sin, if we were overpowered by our temptations, then there is no other planet earth for us. Other world for us is hell. This is very, very serious matter, very, very dangerous matter. From this planet earth, there is no journey towards any other planet. Adam was forgiven. But the second sin committed by man will not be forgiven. Forgiveness was at the time of first sin. But of the second sin, there is no forgiveness. It is very clear in the Quran. When after the committed first sin, Adam said, "O God, forgive me." When Adam committed the first sin, he prayed, "O God, forgive me." So God said, "Yes." I will forgive me, go to the planet Earth and try again to prepare yourself to find re-entry in the paradise. So Adam was sent here. But again there is a verse in the Quran that in the hereafter, some people will say that, "O God, we committed sin, we were overpowered by our temptations, so send us again to this planet, and we will do good deed." But God will say that there is no, we will not be given second chance. You will not be given second chance. Now there is nothing for you except either hell or paradise. So this is, for us is the second chance. After this, there is no third chance. For Adam, it was first chance. And for us, it is second chance. After second chance, there is no third chance. after this second charge, we have to enter into the world, in the world hereafter. This is very, 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 very dangerous position, very, very serious position. This is very, very serious position. So we have to rethink, we have to redesign, we have to reassess the whole matter. And the crucial point is that we must know that we are here not to enjoy, we are here not to live in luxury, we are here not to find a happy life. No, this world is not meant for this purpose. The only purpose for which this world was created is that it is a preparatory ground. It gives us all those facilities by availing which we can prepare ourselves. So all these things are as a facility rather than blessing. All those things we find here is as a facility and not as a blessing. All these things are for one purpose, to give us life, to give us its strength, to give us health. All those things that are available in this planet Earth are only facilities and not blessing. What I mean by facility, it is that these things are only for one purpose, to give us health, to give us peace, to give us opportunity, to give us thinking material, to give us a lesson, to give us time to work. So all these things are only facilities. Time, energy, life support system. All these things are like facilities. You know, when a student enters the examination hall, there are many facilities. There are so many facilities. There are chairs, there are tables, there are waters. There are different facilities. But these facilities are not to provide pleasure, to provide comfort to students. No. These facilities are only to give him chance, to give him time, to give him peace, so that he may do his work. He may fulfill his papers. So the only purpose for a student when he is in examination hall is to avail all those opportunities and clarify his papers. That's all. So all those facilities which are here in this earth, in this world, are simply facilities and not blessings. We are not told to go to jungle, we are not told to go to mountain. No. This kind of rahbaniyat is not required by God. We can utilize all those things which are here in this world, but as a need, not as a pleasure. For example, if you are living in a house, you are using a car, you are using a telephone. So all these things are facilities item. If you are using these things to prepare yourself for paradise, for purifying your soul, then it is lawful. Then you are allowed. You are not required to go to mountain. You are not required to go to jungle. No. You can utilize all those things which are available on this earth, but for one purpose, that is to prepare ourselves. That is quite lawful for you. We created a civilization. It was our dream. It was man's dream. Man wanted to build a beautiful world to live in. So he created civilization. What is civilization? Civilization means to provide all those good things for you, all those things that all those comfortable things for you. But this was not the creation plan of God. So now, after waiting thousand and thousand years, God has decided to liquidate all these things. Yawma natwi as-samaa katayi sijil al-kutub. So God has decided to liquidate all these things because man failed. Man failed to follow the creation plan of God. Man failed to follow the creation plan of God. He adopted his own agenda. That was eat, drink, and be merry. So this agenda was rejected by God. This world was not created for this purpose. This is the most important lesson from the phenomena that is called global warming. So, global warming is a global warning. It is a divine warning. It is a divine warning. We have to listen those voices from God. We have to understand those indications from God. And we have to refashion our life. We have to redesign our life. We have to reassess our life. Because the time is running out. So only one message I can give you, that understand, that follow the creation plan of God and find entry into paradise. Astaghfirullah li wa lakum ajma'in. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah.